2 days before coming to BC, I was riding in minus 25 degree temperatures in northern Quebec. In those weather and riding conditions, my CKX suit was warm and comfortable. Here in the mountains, that suit worked well, but it also brought my Motorfist mountain gear. Dressing in light layers is key to backcountry riding, and proper inner layers with a proper shell is crucial for all-day powder riding. The Motorfist gear provided lightweight, a proper fit, along with breathability and ventilation.
I think the number one thing for us riding backcountry or mountains is to dress appropriately, and that's the hardest thing. Is most people tend to get chilly, or they get too warm because they're sweating because they're wearing their heavy clothing when they come from the east, or that's what they're used to riding in. Layering, definitely learning how to layer, that's your number one aspect of mountain riding. You want to be able to wick that moisture away as soon as you start sweating, because we're going to sweat. We all know we sweat when we ride out here. There's a lot of physical activity. So getting the right layers. Clothing has become so technical now in the industry that it's pretty easy. As long as you get to know what exactly to wear, you're gonna be fine.
No matter your style of riding, layering is key to staying warm and comfortable. You might have the best jacket in the world, but if you combine it with a regular t-shirt, you're gonna compromise your jacket's performance. This is a perfect example of a base layer. It retains warmth, wicks moisture away from your skin, also has an antibacterial material to keep you comfortable. The second layer is there to insulate you and keep you warm while allowing ease of movement.
Long gone are the days of heavy suits that did not breathe nor repel moisture. Also gone are the wool sweaters and fluffy scarves. Today's sledder has many clothing options in brands and styles, but a key consideration should be the riding zone and the type of riding you do. A suit that works well in minus 30 lake riding does not lend itself to tight trail riding in warm weather, nor would it work well in backcountry riding. The outer and inner layers are key to your riding comfort. Underlayers keep you warm, but they should not make you sweat. Too many layers can also restrict your movement, especially in the backcountry. When riding in British Columbia, I tried my trail riding gear, and yes, it worked well. When I put my Motorfist gear on, which is designed for off-trail riding, I definitely noticed a difference. More flexibility, along with more ventilation, allowed me to ride actively with no limitations, and my body temperature never rose. When riding in the backcountry, you know either you or someone else is going to get stuck, and there's going to be some heavy digging involved. Hence, you want to have layers that you can shed quickly and then put back on once that sled is out of the 5 to 8 feet of fluffy snow. Proper gear, along with proper layering for your type of riding and riding conditions, can make a world of difference.
STV is sponsored by Ultimax Belts. Performance proven, performance driven. Triton Trailers, the difference is in the details. And by CKX, wear your passion.
On next week's show, I get out the touring gear and I head back to Ontario for some great trail riding. We will also get around to our talk with Yvonne Dumel and Kane's quest, Somebody Wakes Up on Something That's Definitely Not a Pillow. I'd like to hear from you and I'd like to read your comments, so email me, phil@snowmobilertv.com. Thanks for watching and remember, check out all our videos online at snowmobilertv.com. We'll see you next week here on the snow.